Hey, Rich Estu, Money Maniacs, welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about how socialism always rides on the back of capitalism. How convenient. You ready, set, go. Hey, Money Maniacs, welcome back. Rich Estu, this is Tom coming at you. In this particular video, I just want to talk about a very powerful understanding. In most empires, what occurs is a cycle. And you can look back through history, especially when you're studying monetary history, and see it happen every time. Some country will rise to power thanks to its monetary policy, and its foreign policy, its domestic policy, the way it treats its citizens, how it conducts itself in the world. And as it grows in power and wealth, suddenly there appear public works to help those who are in need and to help build things and to help others have what most of the citizens, you know, don't have. Or if the rich have certain things or certain luxuries, well, then the lower class wants them too. But, you know, it's just starts to hear the talks of, we need a public works program for lower income people. We need a public works program for people who don't have enough wheat in their field. We need a public works program for farmers who were ravished by the famine or by a drought, or it could be anything. It's not, and we could go back through history, and guess what? History shows that public works appear after an empire starts to form and becomes wealthy. That's just normal, because the citizens become so comfortable, and they get so used to life being good because their empire is so big and they have so many resources, that they look around and think, you know, everyone should live this way. It's only fair that everyone have the same opportunities that we have. And often, sometimes empires expand with the best of intentions to bring freedom to, or to bring rights to, or to help this people, or to help. I mean, actually, what you're always talking about when an empire expands is the acquisition of resources, whether it be land, or whether it be minerals, or whether it be timber, or animals, or people to join their armies. Now, what's another thing that occurs when an empire grows is the idea that, well, you form a military to protect your borders because you're starting to get wealthy and people are starting to try and take that away from you, and they want to take your resources. You got to defend yourself. And then, of course, once you have a military, well, eventually you have to use it. So then that military starts to expand and gather more resources. And of course, there's all kinds of fortunes made and power plays and all kinds of people who want to be famous, and everybody wants to rule the world. So that always expands and ends up in a bad monetary and foreign policy choices that always eventually bring an empire to its knees. It has never failed. It has been consistent throughout history. It's almost cliche. But the important part about this video is the idea that socialism, the idea of everything being equal and everyone being fair and everyone working together to build the country, to help the downtrodden and lift them up and provide for everyone so that no one goes without, always has to ride on the back of a producer. Because remember something, we're dealing with human beings, and human beings are flawed. A lot of human beings don't want to do anything. They don't want to work. They just want to sit around and maybe even go hungry. They're not willing to put forth the effort to learn a new skill, or to start a business, or to even just plant a field or plant a garden for themselves, because they know that if they cry about it enough, someone will feel bad for them. Some citizen somewhere will feel guilty, even if it's just because his religion tells him to feel guilty, or because he did something in his life that maybe he should feel guilty for. Maybe he did something that wasn't such a good thing, and so he wants to try and make up it in some way, and you need help, so I'm going to help you, and hopefully that'll get me credit with whoever my creator is. So they know that someone will give them something if they cry about it loud enough. And then what happens, especially as an empire starts to grow and become wealthy, there are the resources that are extra to go ahead and try. Let's try this out. Maybe we'll get it right this time. Maybe these public works will be the perfect balance, and we won't overspend and we won't give away too much, and we'll actually help people transition from being in trouble or being poor and get them into the productive, sit into productive citizenship that they should be in, where they actually not only support themselves but provide value for the whole community. See, they actually do something that's valuable. Even garbage collectors are valuable. Maybe they sweep the streets. Maybe they dig ditches. Maybe they just babysit. Maybe they walk dogs. Listen, all of those jobs are extremely valuable, especially if you're the person that's looking to pay someone to do them because you don't have the time to do it yourself. Back through history, it always happens that these programs start to form. But they have to form on the back of efforts of people who are working. Now, one of the things that you're probably even witnessing right now is everybody's looking for the free stimulus check and the free monthly income. Everybody's waiting because everything's been locked down. We're not allowed to go back to work. My job isn't essential to the government, and so I have to sit home, and I'm losing money, and I'm getting hungry, and my family's getting hungry, and I'm running out of food, and guess what? The store doesn't even have stuff in the shelves anymore. I've got to do something. So they're looking for this universal base income and these stimulus checks that are sometimes coming and sometimes don't, and when they do, they're not as much as you thought they would be. The point is, while all these people are home, not working, there are others who are out still working, who are being taxed and will continue to be taxed, so that all the other folks who are non-essential can stay home and get their stimulus checks someday, some year, sometime in the future, they might get their stimulus check. Now, that's a whole nother video, because the stimulus check and the stimulus packages, that's a whole nother thing that I would need to talk about. But just really briefly, most of that money goes to large corporations, rich lobbyists, and of course also the Federal Reserve and the central banking system. That's just a fact. When you follow the money, that's where it went. And there's all kinds of ways to tell where it went despite the gag order on the stimulus package itself and how it's being spent. It's really easy to deduce it. Back to socialism riding on the back of capitalism. Without somebody who works and generates some kind of value, there's no way to create a tax to be able to take that money and give it to somebody else who needs help, quote unquote, right? See, that's the thing. Government doesn't provide value. It only takes from its citizens and then redistributes. This is a very important fact. You need to study this if you don't believe me. Don't just write this off. Go look it up. A government's purpose is not to generate value. It doesn't generate value. In fact, your elected officials do not bring value at all. They're supposed to represent your voice. Nowadays, they don't even bother doing that. In fact, I was speaking with a lawyer out of New York City who claimed that the Congress has not been effective for a few decades. Our United States Congress has not been legally effective for decades simply because of all the special interests and all of the political issues that pop up when something real tries to get done. So that's a whole nother video again. The idea here is that if somebody's not working, right, you can't tax them. And so since the government can't just create money, it has to tax to get money, then redistribute it. So if everybody stopped working, there would be no tax base. There would be no money. And some people say, well, they'll get tax base through consumption because you still got sales tax and you still got, you know, licensing and permits, and you've got, there are, I mean, thousands of ways the government generates revenue. And that's true. But think about it. If no one has any income, right, so they can't go buy things, and they're not working, so you can't tax them. And since they have no income, and no money and they're starving, they can't pay for licenses. They can't pay for permits or construction permits or all the different taxes that are based on the idea of someone producing something, right? When somebody or everybody or most people decide, hey, I just want the government to pay me my universal base income and I'm just going to stay home, then there's nothing to tax because they're not working. And if enough people do that, then the system falls apart and you have government agencies shutting down and firing employees and putting them on furlough and permanently laying them off and programs shutting down left, right, and center, and you have monetary systems that fail and all kinds of challenges. I mean, that's, you're talking about serious, serious challenges. Oh, wait, that's what we're facing right now because the economy has been forcefully shut down. So what's the saving grace for the United States? Well, right now, the saving grace is that the Federal Reserve is just printing money nonstop by just typing numbers into a computer. They don't even bother actually running a printer and printing out the bills at all. And now the Treasury, of course, is talking about creating a palladium coin that's a $1 trillion palladium coin. Can you believe that? You'd be able to hold $1 trillion in your hand, a coin, $1 trillion coin. I just don't buy it, but that's my personal opinion. So back to socialism on top of capitalism. If enough people are sitting home receiving money and not doing anything, watching TV and eating pizza and relaxing and having fun all day long, right? Because the government is sending them checks. Every month, they get their free living. What do you think the people who are working are going to do? The people who are out there still slaving away and getting taxed harder and harder every day because, well, you got to pay these people who are sitting at home. You got to give them their universal base income. What do you think they'll do? They'll start to wise up. Why am I working and getting taxed when everybody else is just sitting home? That is human nature. It's been proven time and time again, experiment after experiment, and in history, every time, every empire, when you have these public works, people start to resent that everybody is getting the same and they're still working, getting taxed. So what do? They stop working. They stay home and they get their tax. They get their check too. How long do you think any nation can function that way? If you don't have a capitalist who is working, now, I can tell you what has happened in the past also. People have been forced to work jobs they didn't want under pain of death. There were empires who said, if your father was a blacksmith, you must become a blacksmith or we will kill you and you must work. That's not freedom, that's slavery. You're not only being told that you have to work, but you're being told what kind of job you're supposed to take. That's exactly what happens when the government or elected officials control everything. You know, the USSR was a wonderful failure. It was the most scientific experiment in sociology and political economics ever put forth on the face of the planet by some of the smartest human beings on the planet, especially at that time. Think how smart the forefathers of the United States were. These guys were smart too, and they thought they had it all figured out. They couldn't even manufacture pantyhose well. They couldn't figure it out. These were the smartest men on the planet at the time. They couldn't get it right. Capitalism relies on the free market and all of the millions and millions and trillions of different interests, individual interests, in self-serving and generating revenue through the products and the services that they provide and the hard work they put in. Socialism always rides on the back of that. Because socialism is always about legalized thievery from a producer. If you're a producer, I pass a law and I get a percentage of whatever you produce. And since I'm in charge of the fund, Muchin, I get to decide who gets that money, which makes me very powerful. And boy, I like being powerful. But if you don't have the capitalist and you don't have the producers, you can't put a tax on. If everybody stops working, who do you tax? Well, then you have to pass those laws I talked about where you force people to work and you tell them what jobs they're allowed to work at. So think about that the next time you look at the news and you see people asking for universal base income, or you see people looking for their stimulus checks. Ooh, I can't wait. Or they're saying, I'm out of a job. There's nothing I can do. I'm unemployed. Listen, this is the United States of America. This is the land of opportunity. Despite how messed up it is right now, there is opportunity everywhere, every day, no matter the circumstance. In fact, I'm taking advantage of this opportunity to make these videos for you to hopefully help you and inspire you to look around. There's always a need. You just need to find that need and stop pretending that there's nothing to do. That would be my suggestion. So, socialism always rides on the back of capitalism. Now the trick is to get rid of the socialism and get back to being capitalists. Get back to being responsible value exchangers. Get back to providing the best quality product for the best price for the superpower consumer and providing them something that they love so much that they come back again and again and again. And everybody wins. All right, everybody. I hope that was helpful. It's very important to look this stuff up on your own, though. Don't just take my word for it. Go back and really understand how socialism rides on the back of capitalism. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and make sure you subscribe to the channel. We would love to have you back for the next one. See you guys real soon.